Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your most favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right. You know, brothers and sisters, I haven't been on here making videos too much because I've just been, what's the right word? I think I mentioned it in the video I made about with the bowling pins and all that, which was August the 7th. I made that video. I've been sitting in astonishment, brothers and sisters. I'll say that. I've been sitting in astonishment because I knew all these things are going to happen. The Lord's been showing me over the years. I've been making videos about it. And I've been in astonishment about the fact that the time is now for destruction and judgment upon this world. Number two, I'm astonished that lots of Christians think it's great to see people destroyed. And as the Lord Jesus told John and James, you know, he called them sons of thunder, and he said, you don't know what spirit you are of, when they wanted to call down fire on a city of in Samaria. And number three, I've been astonished. I'm astonished. Since I've been on YouTube, I've been astonished at the amount of false prophets and nonsensical peoples not called by God who continue to have thousands and thousands and thousands of people to follow them and take them seriously, even though they've given so many false prophecies, false words from the Lord. But listen to me, you know, destruction is coming, and people need to make peace with God. I'll put it that way. It's time to repent. You know, I'm not, I haven't ever really done that. The Lord didn't really call me to, so far as I know, the Lord hasn't really called me to call out people's names and false prophets and all that. But I will say, people need to repent. You know, lots of times people, you know, by definition aren't necessarily what you would want to call a biblical false prophet, in the fact that their intention and their heart's desire is not to deceive people or whatever you want to call it. Their heart's desire is to be used by God so desperately. And they have, you know, God gave them a dollar and they're trying to spend a million. You know, God, you know, John the Baptist said, you know, no man can do anything unless, God gives it to them. Because his disciples were saying, hey, you know, Jesus's people are baptizing more than we are, you know. And John said, he must increase and I must decrease. And John said that, you know, no man can have anything unless the Father gives it to them. So, you know, God has given people sometimes something, you know, like a word or a dream, and then they took it as a license, you know, a license to, run with it. They've used poetic license with the words they got from the Lord, with the dreams they got from the Lord, and they begin to see themselves as some kind of Elijah, some kind of a somebody like that. And you know, you probably don't know, there was a man called William Branham, who was a mighty man of God who heard from the Lord mightily from the 30s, 40s, 50s and stuff like that. And he began to say he was Elijah. He began to preach without coming out and saying it, that he was the prophet. He was the Elijah. And he was the final sign, you know, before the end times. And he began to give false prophecies. It didn't happen that the Lord would return or the tribulation would begin in 1974 or 77, something like that. No, that did not happen. But what happened is other men of God, like Kenneth Hagin, Dad Hagin, who died in 2003, got a word from the Lord that God was going to take him out if he didn't repent. And he was, in the year, 1965, and he was killed in a car wreck. But I hear from the Lord, brothers and sisters, those days are over. Those days are over. The time is near, even at the door. The time is at hand. And the word I heard from the Lord this morning, you know, brothers and sisters, I'm not a fearmonger, but this is the word of the Lord. Collapse, total economic collapse is at the door. You know, the other day I think the Lord was showing me that, you know, there would be a little bit of a, you know, that we'll see a little bit of where it's like not doing so bad. Like what it's doing now, like what stock market's doing now is already not bad compared to what it's going to be. And I believe it's going to go down to 5,000. Now, I don't know how many days or weeks that's going to take. Maybe it's going to be with the Shemitah time. I don't know. The stock market, the Dow, will go to 5,000 in the near future. I don't know the date. But anyway, brothers and sisters, it's going to be a total economic, worldwide economic collapse. And, I'm saying these things because I know that there's people watching who are not spiritually prepared and not spiritually right with God. You know, that's why I'm just saying this. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day to get right with God. You know, and I always give that message, not as a fearmonger. You guys know that. You know, you see these people that don't believe in the rapture on here, and they're the most famous people on YouTube because they're preaching, fear. And then you have these people on television like Jim Baker, on the radio, Steve Quayle, these people, they don't believe in the rapture. Well, guess what? How convenient. Because they're selling gold and silver, they're selling survivalist stuff. And of course, it's called a conflict of interest. Brothers and sisters, there are many people watching this video who are not going to go in the rapture because they are not ready, they're not sanctified, they're not set apart to meet the Lord. Now, if you have come like myself, who came from a Baptist background here in the Bible Belt of the South, southeastern part of the United States, you know, you've been told that you can say a prayer when you're 10 years old, live like the devil all your life, and you're going to go in the rapture, you're going to go to heaven, and everything's hunky-dory. Now, that's the doctrine that's been fed to you by the words and cunning wisdom of men. But I'm here to tell you what the Word of God says. James chapter 2. Be ye therefore doers of the Word, not hearers only. James, the half-brother of Jesus, said, you have your faith without works. I show you my faith by my works. Don't you know, O vain man, faith without works is dead. Jesus said in Revelation 3:10, because you have kept the word of my patience, I will keep you out of the hour of temptation that will come upon the whole earth to try all the people of this earth. Luke 21:36, the Lord Jesus speaking again about the tribulation. He said, watch therefore and pray always that you be counted worthy to escape these things, the tribulation, and stand before the Son of Man. He didn't say pray one time. He said, watch always and pray that you be kind of worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. Listen, brothers and sisters, you know, I'm just making this video to get it out right now. And I've got so many things. That's why I've been in astonishment. And all the things, the Lord, I want to say this. All the things the Lord's been telling me, besides about what's coming, which everybody's so concerned about, how it affects them. And that's the problem. Keep your eyes on Jesus, like Peter when he was walking on the water. And he had his eyes on Jesus. He was walking on the water. As soon as he started looking at the storms, he sank. Keep your eyes on Jesus. The things that the Lord's been talking to me about, brothers and sisters, is about his dealings with Israel and what's going on with Israel. Nehemiah and Zechariah rebuilding the wall, building up Jerusalem, building up Israel for the time of Jacob's trouble, the tribulation period, is all about Israel. All these false prophets on YouTube, you know, if the Lord leads me, I'm going to make a video about them. The 144,000 witnesses are males, men of the house of Israel, 12,000 from those different tribes. They are not Gentile women wearing scarves on their head on YouTube. The Bible is literally correct. The Bible is to be taken literally unless it states otherwise. And it says 144,000, which is a literal number, with 12,000 from all those tribes, which is literally 12,000 and literally from those bloodlines that's spoken. They will be men. That's just one of the nonsensical things that's on YouTube. Brothers and sisters, go back to the fundamentals. Many of you have never heard the fundamentals. You came out of these Protestant denominations and Catholic churches with the charismatic movement. Lots of people who came out of the charismatic movement. The problem, And one of the signs of the end times in the charismatic movement, no foundation in the Word of God. All spiritual, and then you got all these spooky spiritual nuts, false prophets coming out of the woodwork, leading people astray with all this nonsensical, unbiblical, anti-biblical nonsense. That's why I believe, brothers and sisters, that, you know, for myself and people like me, you know, people that came out of that Baptist tradition of being rooted and grounded in the Word, but yet, you know, they have those doctrines that are incompatible with the truth. And brothers and sisters, this is what I call myself, a truth seeker. I don't let my doctrine interpret the Word of God. I'll let the Word of God interpret my doctrine. I don't look at the Bible through the rose-colored glasses of doctrine, but I look at my doctrine through the Word of God. And that's what you have to do, brothers and sisters. You have to let the Bible interpret itself. You need to pray, as the Word of God tells us, the Bible is spiritually discerned. God can lead you by His Spirit in understanding the Word. So you have to go back to the basics. And the basics is when you're in the boat and Jesus says, come out here on the water to me, and you step out on that water, you keep your eyes on Jesus. This is something you can tell a three-year-old, you know, keep your eyes on me. Don't run in the road. Don't climb under the sink and drink some of the, cleaning fluid under the sink. I mean, don't run out in the road. Don't, you know, hold my hand when we're crossing the road. These basic things is where the victory is. And this is the victory that God has given us. Hallelujah, that Christ Jesus has died for us. He himself has become our sin. He has delivered us and translated us from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of his dear Son, the Bible tells us in Colossians. The Lord has delivered us. The Lord has translated us. The Lord has set us free. Hallelujah, I think it's Titus, as a matter of fact. Hallelujah, praise God, through whom all blessings flow. The Lord has delivered us, brothers and sisters. So it's a time of separation from the world. Prepare your hearts to not be troubled, but you believe in God, you believe also in the Lord Jesus Christ. John chapter 14. In his Father's house, Jesus said, in my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you, where I am that you may be also. And I will come again and receive you unto myself. The Lord's going to receive us unto himself and take us before the day of wrath, says the Lord. That's from the Lord, brothers and sisters. Again, the Lord is confirming he's going to take the true church, the true bride, those who are truly born again, to heaven. There are churches filled with false converts. The church is filled with tares and so much, brothers and sisters, as part of the end time. So that's what you need to do. Stop worrying about the stock market. You know, look, brothers and sisters, I'm going to say this again, those of you who know. You know, the Lord made a way. I did all the orphanages and all that stuff when I started out of my own savings that the Lord gave me. The Lord made a way for me to have this money, a piece of land that I inherited from my great-great long-lost aunt who had no children. And I put that money in the stock market. And in 2008, while I was in the Philippines in the middle of nowhere with no internet, stock market went down like 25 or 30%, 35%, whatever it was. I lost a bunch of money at that time. But, you know, the Lord didn't even say anything. You know, I knew the stock market was going to go down. The Lord told me, but the Lord told me don't worry about it. And then now, again, I've still got the funds invested. And the Lord said, don't worry about it. See, that's the thing about it. When you have, it's nothing wrong with using good common sense and all that. I'm not saying that, but put your faith and trust in the Lord. Don't trust in the things of this world. And in the end times, it says in James again that, you know, that the people will be throwing their silver and gold in the streets, and that, James says, you know, weep and howl, ye rich men who have stored up your treasure for the last days. You know, it's going to be useless. Money is useless. You can't eat money. And money can't, you can't buy your way to heaven. And so, brothers and sisters, get your eyes off of those things. Separate yourself from the world today. It's a time of separation. I need to come back and make more videos, brothers and sisters, with these proclamations. I have many proclamations. Just because I'm saying it in a low tone doesn't mean it's not a proclamation from the Lord. It's the somberness of the Lord is upon me, you know, just to say this in a quiet voice. not to say it in hard preaching. It's from the Lord. Prepare yourself. Separate yourself. Prepare yourself spiritually. Separate yourself from the world. The day is at hand. You know, be ready against the third day. That's sanctify yourself. Rededicate your life to the Lord today. Be at peace with God. Make sure there's no enmity between you and the Lord. Now, all these people, you know, if you know there's all these people with all this doctrine about you, say the sinner's prayer, as I've said, and then just live like hell all you want. You don't have to repent anymore and all that. Listen, those people have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof. Do you see any gifts of the Spirit in these churches? No. Their excuse is, oh, that's ceased with the apostles. They have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof. That's how they justify their lack of power. But the real reason why they have no power is because they have not obeyed the Scripture, 2 Chronicles 7:14, where King Solomon, speaking by the Spirit of God, said, if my people, who are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, their individual, repent, I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. America has refused to repent, as we know. The judgment of the Lord is at the door for the United States, brothers and sisters. And we Christians, we need to be prepared and right with God. Be right with God, be right with God, be right with God. Get your eyes off of the world. I'll put it that way. It's going to get worse. The only reason why we need to talk about the world is to talk to our relatives. But I'm telling you, most people are not going to listen. I even told my own family on this, before I made the video on the 7th, I told my family what's going to happen. And then they were worried about it messing up their plans. And they don't even have money in the stock market. And I told them, and they're only worried about how it would affect their personal lives and their plans. And then it's happened, and then I haven't heard anything from them. As a matter of fact, they blocked me on Facebook. Some of my immediate family relatives blocked me on Facebook. I don't post on anybody's Facebook, just on my own. And I guess that it's, the conviction is just something, you know, they're not going to respond to the conviction. If you're convicted and you don't repent, I mean, you either get mad or glad. That's what they say. If you're in a church where people are non-believers sitting in the church and lukewarm, the preacher's not preaching, because they either need to get mad and leave or repent and be glad. You know, get mad or get glad if there's any real preaching going on. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. And we're almost out of here. In the day of the mockers of the true prophets of God and the false prophets and all those people, the day is fast approaching when they will be here during the tribulation. So that's what, you know, the Lord told me a long time ago. It's, you know, these people who are preaching that, I mean, they're going to be here. That's why they're preaching that. From their false prophecies, their false teachings, by the grace of God, they'll repent of that. And I pray that if they, you know, during the tribulation, they will be tribulation saints, and they will become true prophets of God and be used by God mightily during that time. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. God bless you.